My name is Merrick Gertler, and it is my great privilege to serve the University of Toronto as its 16th president. Today, I have the additional privilege of assisting Chancellor Rose Patton in conducting this special honorary degree ceremony. I bid a warm welcome to everyone who has joined us virtually from around the globe. In compliance with public health directives in the province of Ontario to help stop the spread of COVID-19, we are conferring all honorary degrees virtually. In normal times, this ceremony would have occurred during a convocation ceremony, where we gather in person to celebrate the achievements of our U of T graduates and our honorary degree recipients together. And so I would like to thank our honorary graduate, University Professor Emeritus Geoffrey Hinton, for agreeing to accept the University of Toronto's highest honor under these unique circumstances. I would also like to thank Ms. Emma Hinton for agreeing to serve as hooder, an important ceremonial role in the conferral portion of the convocation ceremony. It is now my great honor to present Professor Geoffrey Hinton. University Professor Emeritus Geoffrey Hinton is internationally recognized and admired as a pioneer in the field of deep learning as a mode of artificial intelligence. He's a driving force behind the development of the field of neural computation and neural networks, a multidisciplinary research enterprise within machine learning that is linked not only to AI, but to cognitive psychology, neurobiology, mathematical optimization, information theory, statistical physics, and probabilistic modeling. The computational paradigms developed by Professor Hinton have had a profound impact on work in cognitive science, creating new ways of thinking about information processing and learning. The algorithms he developed are used in a wide variety of applications and are behind the data processing that occurs on billions of smartphones and tablets worldwide for speech recognition, automated search functions, computer vision, and language translation. Professor Hinton's seminal contributions and his profound impact on the field have led to broad recognition within the technology world, to multiple profiles in the popular press around the globe, and to numerous scholarly accolades. Most recently, he was recognized with the Nobel Prize of Computing, the ACM AM Turing Award, which was awarded jointly to Professor Hinton and fellow deep learning pioneers Joshua Bengio and Yann LeCun. He has also been named a Companion of the Order of Canada, recognizing a lifetime of outstanding achievement and merit of the highest degree. He has spent nearly 30 years of his stellar academic career at the University of Toronto, where he was named a university professor in 2006. Due in large part to Hinton's leadership and his exemplary mentorship of young scholars, U of T has developed into a global leader in these areas. The recently established Vector Institute, with its growing AI faculty working at U of T and in partner hospitals, was directly inspired by Hinton's leadership, and Hinton today is its chief scientific advisor. For his excellence in the academy as an internationally renowned pioneer in the field of deep learning as a mode of artificial intelligence, Chancellor Patton, on behalf of the Governing Council, I ask you to confer the degree of Doctor of Science honoris causa upon Geoffrey Hinton.
On behalf of the University of Toronto and by virtue of the authority vested in me, I have the great honor and pleasure of conferring on you, Geoffrey Hinton, the degree of Doctor of Science honoris causa.
As the newest member of the University of Toronto alumni, Dr. Hinton, I extend warmest congratulations on behalf of the entire U of T community. I now invite you to deliver your address.
When I was a graduate student in the 1970s, I was captivated by an idea, and I spent the next 50 years trying to show that this idea was correct. The idea is that a big network of neurons that starts life with almost no innate knowledge can acquire complicated skills by using a simple learning rule to update the strengths of the connections between neurons. I decided that this must be how the brain worked. Unfortunately, this idea was completely rejected by the artificial intelligence community. They were utterly confident that the way to understand intelligence was to ignore the hardware and to focus on reasoning. They decided that human reasoning must involve using rules of inference to manipulate internal symbolic expressions. Strings of words go into your ears, strings of words come out of your mouth, and in between, there must be something that manipulates the incoming strings to produce the outgoing strings. Logic was that something. What could be more obvious? 20th century AI was fully committed to the biologically unrealistic idea that knowledge needs to be programmed into a system by people, rather than emerging from the interaction between a big data set and a big neural network running a simple learning rule. In the first 30 years of my career, I invented several different ways of getting neural networks to learn from data, and some of them were moderately successful. But the AI community always thought that my approach was a crazy dead end. I did most of my work in Canada because I like the social system here, and I particularly like the fact that Canada is willing to fund scientists to do basic curiosity-driven research with no immediate payoff. In 2009, two of the graduate students I was advising, George Dahl and Abdulrahman Mohammed, showed that a new deep learning algorithm that I had been working on was actually better than existing technology at speech recognition. Then two more of my graduate students, Alex Krishevsky and Ilya Sutskova, showed that deep learning worked much better than existing computer vision systems at recognizing objects and images. A few years later, deep learning proved to be much better than symbolic AI at machine translation. Deep learning is now everywhere. I think the take-home lesson of this story is that you should never give up on an idea that you think is obviously correct, and you should get yourself some really smart graduate students.
Thank you, Dr. Hinton. And let me say, you have inspired us with your lifetime career and accomplishments. And today, you have inspired us with your words. We are delighted to count you among the most distinguished members of our alumni community. In closing, I offer warm congratulations to you and to all graduates in the class of 2021.